Okay, now we proceed to learning outcome number two. Consumer decision making process is, this is one of the important topic in chapter three. Analyze the component of consumer decision making process. You can see based on your book, page 48, there are five steps involved in the consumer decision making process. Then we are going to go in details later. So the first step is need recognition. Number two is information search. Three, evaluation of alternative. Number four is purchase. And number five is post-purchase behavior. We go to the first step. So that, what is consumer decision making process? It's a five-step process used by any consumers when they want to buy goods or services in our daily life. When we as a consumer want to buy a product or services, this is actually the process that consumer need to undergo in order to before they bought the product or services. Okay, step number one is need recognition, a result of imbalance between the actual and desired state of the consumer. What happened in this first stage as a consumer, kita akan mengenal pasti apa kemahuan dan kehendak kita. And normally this need recognition is actually stimulated, dirangsang oleh two factors, the internal stimuli and the external stimuli. So it's actually meant by stimuli, or the word from stimulus. It's actually any unit of input that affecting one of the more of our five senses. We have five senses. First is our sight. Number two is smell, taste, touch, and also hearing. So contoh macam bila perut kita berbunyi tu, bila lapar tu, so that actually a cue to us, stimulate us. Bila lapar buat apa? Of course we go and find something to eat. For external stimuli, it's actually referring to a marketing effort done by the marketeers. To page 49, you can see that example given, IKEA. IKEA use bold orange, pink and green colors for their furniture in order to create some sort of recognition among consumers to buy IKEA products. Okay, we proceed to the step number two, which is the information search, mencari maklumat. So in information search, divided into two, the internal information search and also the external information search. Okay, internal mean that we recall from our previous memory. For example, if you have an experience buying or eating in that restaurant, so you just recall from your past experience of going to that restaurant. Internal information search, this is normally we did in our world today, isn't it? Okay, a good example of finding an information search, external information search, is going through a Google engine. Contoh macam ni, if you buying a laptop, for example, you need to find some sort of information about the laptop that you want to buy. Okay, so step number three is evaluation of alternative. We go back to our previous example, nak beli laptop. We've listed three options. This one is HP, number two is Lenovo, number three is Acer. Alternative first, analyze the product attributes. What are the features and performance of the product? For people like HP, maybe the design much more good compared to Acer. Two, use the cut-off criteria. So what is actually your criteria of buying? For example, you need to bought a laptop cost you around 2,000. And number three, of course, you rank your option based on the attributes by the importance. So kena ranking kan dia, which one yang preferred most. Then step number four, of course, once we have evaluate which one of your preferred option, step number four is to purchase the product that you want to buy. Okay, whether you want to buy or not, when you want to buy, what to buy, where to buy, and how to pay. This is okay. Last but not least, step number five is post purchase behavior. Find consumer selepas pembelian, itu maksud post purchase. So when buying products, consumer normally expect certain outcomes from the purchase. It's like our expectation. Expectation are met, determine whether the consumer is satisfied or dissatisfied with the product. So in this post-purchase behavior, ada satu term yang dipanggil sebagai cognitive dissonance. The inattention that consumer experience after recognizing an inconsistency. Tu dia punya keyword ya. Between the behavior of the consumer and values or opinion of the consumers. So how to reduce this cognitive dissonance? Okay. So first, we as consumers, of course we need to seek information before we bought the product. So number one, number two, avoiding any information that contradicts with the purchase decision. Number three, revoking the original decision by returning the product. As a marketers or as a seller, what we can do first, you need to really communicate with the consumers in terms of the product information. Number two, of course, once you have sell the product or services, you need to do a follow-up. If you buy any products, they will give you a warranty and guarantee. You also can give service during and after the sales. So this kind of effort done by the sellers or marketeers can help reduce the cognitive dissonance among the consumers.